Hey guys, it's time to do a camera test of the new Samsung Galaxy C8. It's been a while I've done one of these. I want to see what Samsung is doing with their mid-range dual camera system compared to their flagship dual camera system on the Galaxy Note 8. I mean, a lot of things are similar here. The C8 takes the same camera UI from the Galaxy Note 8. Of course, there's no optical zoom, but we do have a selfie focus mode, which gives you the front camera portrait shot. So this is something that you don't even see on the Note 8. So before we begin, just to let you know about the camera specs, we got a 13 megapixel plus 5 megapixel combination dual camera setup on the C8 versus a 12MP dual camera setup on the Note 8. And on the front, we got 16 on the C8 and 8 megapixel on the Galaxy Note 8. Let's get to the good stuff. All right, first we have this image, and I have to say it's looking pretty good on both phones. The Galaxy C8 compares nicely to the Note 8 when you look at the phone, like first look wise. It's a nice bright daylight shot, excellent for this mid-range bad boy. Obviously, when you zoom in, you see things more clear and sharper on the Galaxy Note 8, like the floor with all of its texture and everything. A random leaf in your face, and not bad on the Galaxy C8, just a little extra exposed compared to your Note 8. On to the live focus stuff, and wow, for a budget phone, the C8 is pulling off some good portrait looks. The execution of the live focus is obviously more intelligent on the Note 8, as you can tell, slightly around the edges, but I'm pretty impressed, guys. Another live focus shot on a rather difficult subject, the freaking sunflower with all the leaves and everything. And gotta say, nice try, C8, but you can see the Note 8 in these kind of situations tends to go better. The dual camera, flagship dual camera, will definitely do better than the mid-range one. And now, without the live focus, and wow, I actually like it better on the Galaxy C8. Colors are popping out more if you look at the middle part of the sunflower. A close rose shot, and the Note 8 is doing better at exposing the background compared to the Galaxy C8. Although I really like the picture on the C8 as well, both are amazing here. Next we have a daylight picture of a random plant, pink leaves, and the C8 does a pretty good job at keeping the clarity and sharpness, while the Note 8 obviously does all of that with a better color reproduction. But you can see it's not bad, a bright background shot, and in situations like this, Note 8 will do a better job in exposing the dark area, but overall it looks nice on both phones. Again, similar situation here, but the picture looks good on both. I mean, you can definitely see that C8 does a very comparable job against the best of Samsung. Another live focus comparison, and like I said, it's a different execution on both phones. Note 8 actually zooms in when you switch to the live focus mode, while the Galaxy C8 doesn't. So here the C8 is definitely struggling around the edges of the subject compared to a pretty perfect result of the Galaxy Note 8. Next we have the silencer comparison, and Note 8 really going deep in here with the details, and of course that's what you get with the better sensor, and you know, you're paying more, you're getting better compared to C8, which is doing a okay job in this kind of situation. And some indoor shots, and this is where your money really starts to pay for the flagship stuff. I mean, the quality, brightness, sharpness, all that stuff is well maintained, but still you can see how C8 performs the mid-range dual camera for the price. It looks pretty reasonable to me. Again, you guys are the judge here. It's open for your opinion. And quick selfie test, and like I said, with, you know, phones like Oppo F5, the megapixel are nothing. I mean, it's all about the sensors. Samsung's flagship phones with 8 megapixel front camera have more details compared to a 16 megapixel mid-range front camera. The selfie focus is an extra addition, but don't expect any amazing results. I mean, it's very fakey looky feature. I mean, right now, only the Pixel phone can do the front portrait. Not even the iPhone 10 can do it perfectly. So, I mean, this is a mid-range phone we're talking about. So, Yeah, mid-range dual camera system on the Galaxy C8 is good for the price and somewhat comparable to the flagship dual camera system from Samsung. A lot of things from Note 8 are skimmed down and brought to the mid-range phone. But yeah, let me know your thoughts down below in the comment section. I actually got a request for this camera test. I hope this will help you in making that purchase decision, whether you want this mid-range phone or not, if you know camera is sort of your preference. And yeah, I will catch you guys in the next one. Peace out.